Hey guys, my name is Matt Johnson, and at the start of 2019, I created a video showing you the exact parts that you need to buy to build a 4K video editing PC for $700. Well, we're now toward the end of the year, and a lot of you have been asking me for an update, so today I'm excited to bring you a video showing you the parts that you need to build a 4K video editing PC for $650. Yes, the price has gone down, but the power has actually gone up. I love when that happens. This computer is going to easily enable you to edit HD and 4K video in Adobe Premiere Pro and in DaVinci Resolve, as well as mix music, stream on Twitch, game, whatever you really want to do. And it should be powerful for years to come. Before we jump into the parts, there are a few quick things you need to know. First, all of the parts that I'm going to be talking about in this video are going to be linked down in the video description. So if you don't want to hear me ramble and want to see the parts, you can do that. The parts will also be featured on my kit page, where they will be nicely organized for you to check out. Second, this video is going to show you the parts that you need to buy, but not how to put them together. Do not worry though, I have a video that I created a while back showing you the exact step-by-step process that you need to take to build this computer, from taking the parts out of the box all the way to turning it on. That video is linked down in the description, and the parts for this build should go together the same way that the parts for that build did. The third thing that you need to know is that for some of the parts, I've included upgrade options for you. So if you have a little more room in your budget and you want to make your video editing experience even faster, you can do that by purchasing these upgraded parts. The fourth and final thing that you need to know is that while this video is about showing you the parts to build a $650 video editing computer, I have another video that you can watch that is going to show you how to build a much higher end video editing computer. So if you have a lot more budget and you want to build something that can edit 4K, 6K footage, raw footage, anything like that, then I would highly recommend checking out that video, and I'll link to it up in the corner and down in the description as well. Now, onto this $650 budget video editing computer build. Up first, let's talk about the motherboard. This is where you're gonna put all of your parts, like your CPU, RAM, and graphics card. I recommend the MSI B450A Pro motherboard. With this motherboard, you are getting a good mix of features for a good price. And you're also getting a motherboard that should work with future AMD CPUs, so you can save some money and not have to upgrade your motherboard if you decide to upgrade your CPU in the future. Now let's talk about the CPU, which I have referred to in the past as the brain of the computer. And this is arguably the most important part of your build, because if you can purchase a CPU with a high number of cores and threads, it is going to make a noticeable difference in how fast you can edit and render video. Here's the good news. AMD released the 3000 series of their CPUs in summer 2019, which have a nice boost in performance over the previous generation. Here's the better news. The release of the 3000 series of CPUs has driven down the cost of the 2000 series of CPUs, which makes them a perfect choice for a budget video editing build. I recommend that you purchase the Ryzen 5 2600 CPU, which is the same CPU that I recommended in my last budget video editing build. Why am I recommending this CPU? Because the price has dropped down to an average of $120. This is a fantastic price to performance ratio for a 6-core 12-thread CPU. If you have a bit more money though, as an upgrade to this CPU, AMD has also dropped the price of the Ryzen 7 2700 CPU, which offers 8 cores and 16 threads of performance. The price is now around $170, and if you can afford this upgrade, you're getting 2 extra cores and 4 extra threads of performance, which is going to make a significant difference in the speed of your editing. Moving on, let's talk about RAM, aka memory, what your computer needs to run its programs. For RAM, I would recommend 16 gigabytes of Corsair LPX memory at 3000 megahertz. This RAM is going to be enough for 4K video editing, but I wouldn't recommend running many other programs while you are video editing. As an upgrade, especially if you find yourself multitasking or editing a lot of longer 4K videos, I would recommend purchasing 32 gigabytes of Corsair Vengeance LPX memory at 3200 megahertz. I ran this amount for years on my desktop, and it worked great for 4K editing. Up next, you have the SSD, which is the very fast hard drive that your computer is going to use to store all of your programs and operating system while you edit videos. For a very fast budget option, I would recommend the Samsung 970 Evo Plus, NVMe 250 gigabyte SSD for $70. If you want more space though, I would recommend the Samsung 970 Evo Plus 500 gigabyte for around $120. There's even a 1 terabyte model for $213 if you want to go crazy. Vinci. Please keep in mind that to edit as fast as possible, I only recommend using the SSD to store your programs, not your video files. As someone that travels a lot, I would recommend purchasing an external hard drive or SSD to edit your videos from. Alternatively, this computer's case will support internal hard drives and SSDs, so if you want to put them inside the case, you have that option as well. I'll be sure to link to some of the hard drives and SSDs that I recommend, both internal and external, down in the video description. Now let's talk about everyone's favorite part of any computer, the graphics card. For this budget build, I would recommend the Radeon RX 570. This GPU is going to work well if you are editing video in Premiere with a lot of effects applied. As an upgrade though, I would also consider the MSI Armor OC Radeon RX 580 for around 180 bucks, or the Gigabyte Gaming RX 590 for 209. The 580 and 590 will both be a bit faster. If you only have a bit of extra money to spend though, I would upgrade your CPU before your graphics card, as video editing programs still rely on the CPU more. Almost done. We need to talk about the power supply, which is going to give all the computer's components the juice that they crave. I would recommend the EVGA 600W power supply, which I'm sure some of you are thinking is total overkill from a power perspective for this computer. But this power supply is consistently on sale for a great price of around $40, which is quite reasonable, so I think it's a great choice. Please keep in mind that this is not a modular power supply, meaning that the cables are permanently attached to the back of it. This can make cable management a bit more difficult, but it does keep the cost down. If you have some extra money though and want easier cable management, I would recommend the EVGA BQ600W power supply, which is semi-modular and should result in a cleaner looking build for not too much more money. Lastly, you need something to put all of these parts inside. The case. One of my favorite current cases is the NZXT H510, which is pretty but still looks professional. There's no RGB or crazy colors, it's just a well-built case that will look good on or under a desk. The roughly $70 price tag isn't bad either. Now I do want you to be aware that the H510 does not have any 5.25 inch expansion bays. This means that you're not going to be able to internally install a Blu-ray or DVD burner. The good news is that you can pick up an external DVD burner for about 25 bucks and an external Blu-ray burner for less than 100. If you really want a case that you can install an internal DVD or Blu-ray burner, I would recommend the Cooler Master HAF 912. This case isn't quite as pretty as the NZXT H510, but has great airflow and thousands of people love it. And that is your $650 video editing PC build. I'm sure some of you are thinking, Matt, there's still a lot that we need to talk about. What about mice, keyboards, speakers, monitors? Don't worry, I have you covered. Linked down in the description are all of the physical accessories that I would recommend that you purchase. I realize that everybody has a different opinion, but this is just what I would recommend. I would pay special attention to the monitors that I recommend, and if you are planning on editing 4K video, I would highly recommend investing in a 4K monitor as well. As far as the operating system goes, I would recommend Windows 10. And I'm gonna link to a Tom's Hardware article down in the video description that's gonna show you how to get that for very cheap or even free. With that, thank you so much for watching. It would be a huge help to me if you would consider liking this video and subscribing if you want to see more PC build videos like this in the future. Please also keep in mind that the prices for these parts can fluctuate from day to day. Also, if any of the parts that I've talked about look significantly more expensive than what I talked about or happen to be out of stock, please leave me a comment down below and let me know so I can update the links in the description and on my kit page with better parts that are actually available. Lastly, please keep in mind that I also have that higher end video editing PC build as well. So if you are editing 4K, 6K, raw footage, 8K, whatever, that video is linked up in the corner and down in the description if you want to build a more powerful video editing computer. Thanks so much for watching and have a great day.